Bom dia, gente. Tudo bem? Como está o tempo hoje? Está nublado e chuvoso, né? Hoje é dia de Super Bowl, né? Então vamos fazer a nossa revisão antes do Super Bowl, né? Para vocês estarem preparados para o exame amanhã. Então vamos lá, gente. Responda com frases completas. Please make sure that you read what's being asked, okay? And so that you don't make mistakes. And one thing that I have noticed as well is that sometimes you leave something blank so that you can go back and do the exercise again. And many of you just forget to go back. So make sure you go back, check your test, look at the dictation, see if your sentence makes sense. Because if it doesn't make sense, if you don't understand what's written, probably it's, you know, you misspelled a word or you didn't understand it, okay? Então vamos lá. So this information here, first we have some questions that are related to the vocab of the lesson, okay? So make sure you go to that first part of the lesson, lesson 8, where you had those four or five little texts from parties, and then the following page was about, you know, the Dia das Mães, Dia dos Pais, Páscoa, etc., etc. So, quais são as festas juninas mais animadas do Brasil? As do Sudeste ou as do Nordeste? So, we saw there that the parties in the festas juninas in the Nordeste are the most famous one, okay? And notice that I am using the superlative, okay? So, which are the most exciting and vibrant festas juninas in Brazil, okay? So, all the questions, you are practicing the vocab and the structures that we have learned, okay? And so, the answer, so when you're asking quais, that's the information I'm looking for. So let's start organizing the sentence. Subject and verb, okay? Always make sure, where is my subject? Where is the verb? Does the verb agree with the subject, okay? Então, quais são as festas juninas mais animadas do Brasil? So you're going to start right there. As festas juninas mais animadas, you know, the most incredible ones, animadas. And notice that animadas has to agree with festas, feminine plural, okay? As festas juninas mais animadas do Brasil. Now the verb, and it's in the plural. So, remember that with third person, you don't have to worry about conjugating the verb. Just repeat the verb. As festas juninas mais animadas do Brasil são as. And then you don't have to say as festas juninas. You just keep the as, okay? As são as do Nordeste. Nordeste. Oh, there's a little bird out here. From my window, I can see the bird in the rain. Oops, Nordeste. Qual é a maior cidade brasileira? So once again, I'm using the superlative, okay? Which is the largest city in Brazil? So remember that maior can either be larger or the largest. What's the difference? When it's the largest, you have to have the article. If you're talking about one city, a maior cidade. Like the best player, jogador masculino, o melhor jogador. The best players, os melhores jogadores. The best female players, as melhores jogadoras. Okay, so the word is the same, okay? So what makes it superlative is the use of the article. Qual é a maior cidade brasileira? So again, subject. A maior cidade brasileira é, look at the verb, repeat the verb, é São Paulo. Nossa. Opa. São Paulo. Ponto. Qual é o menor? So estado is masculine. So now you have the article in the masculine, okay? So which is the smallest American state, okay? And notice, guys, please, nationality in Portuguese is written with letra minúscula, okay? Do not capitalize the nationality. So subject, o menor estado americano é, don't forget the verb, é Rhode Island. Rhode Island. Qual cidade é menor, o Rio ou São Paulo? So here you see that menor, now you're going to compare, okay? So you're going to say Rio is smaller than São Paulo. So you see the form is the same, but you don't have o anymore, okay? So you say Rio, o Rio. And Rio is one of the, usually you don't use the article before names of cities. So you say Las Vegas, Miami, São Paulo, Belo Horizonte, Memphis, okay? But exception, Rio is an exception, okay? Why? Because the word Rio is means Rio, that means river. So that's why you use the article, okay? Então, o Rio de Janeiro, verb é maior. And now, when you are comparing, you have to use do que. Or just que, ok? É maior do que São Paulo. So, São Paulo does not require the use of the article, ok? São Paulo. Ponto. Onde fica o sambódromo? So, the verb ficar can be to stay. But here, the verb ficar is not the verb to stay. It is being used as a linking verb. What's a linking verb? A linking verb is a verb that can substitute for the verb to be. So instead of asking where is, onde é o sambódromo, you use the verb ficar, which is very common, okay? And in English, you have several verbs that behave like this. For example, you can say, this food is good. Or you can use the verbs, this food smells good, this food looks good, this food tastes good. So all these verbs, they're substituting for the verb to be. So they are called linking verbs, okay? So the verb ficar in Portuguese is a linking verb, okay? So it substitutes for the verb ser, only when it indicates location, okay? So it's very common, instead of asking, where is Rio de Janeiro? You ask, onde fica o Rio de Janeiro? O Rio de Janeiro fica na região sudeste. Onde fica o sambódromo? Subject, o sambódromo, so as we saw in class, right? O sambódromo, verbo, fica no Rio de Janeiro, ok? Qual é o ponto alto? And ponto alto means like, what is the summit, ok? Ponto alto means the summit. So that means, qual é a coisa mais importante do Carnaval do Rio? Então, so subject. And notice here that you're using the superlative, ok? Qual é a coisa mais importante. Então, o sujeito, o ponto alto, so like pinnacle, the summit, ok? O ponto alto do Carnaval. Carnaval do Rio de Janeiro. So you see, this whole thing is the subject. O ponto alto do Carnaval do Rio de Janeiro. Now you have the verb. What's the verb? É. O ponto alto do Carnaval do Rio de Janeiro é o desfile, ok? The parade, right? É o desfile das escolas de samba. Que tipo de música é tradicional em Recife? Que tipo de música? What type of music is traditional in Recife? So we saw that in the, it's on the text that I send you the link for you to study the text. And we also worked on the PowerPoint in class. Both of these are available on Canvas. I have the video and the PowerPoint for you. So que tipo de música é tradicional no Recife? So now you're going to start. What kind of music? O frevo. So that is o frevo. Remember, na 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 na, those kids dancing with the umbrella, right? O frevo é verbo. So you have the subject, now you have the verb. É a música tradicional em Recife. Onde estão os trielétricos mais famosos do Brasil? So, once again, you saw the video, right? Os trios é sujeito. Os trios elétricos. And notice the use of the superlative. Where are the most famous? So, how do you know that mais famosos is the most? Because you have os, ok? Os trios elétricos mais famosos, right? So, trio elétricos, the most famous trio elétricos, ok? Mais famosos do Brasil. Verbo estão no Nordeste. Estão em Salvador, né? Salvador, this is where, you know, you saw the video. All that crowd, you know, following the tri elétrico. There is a song, Atrás do Tri Elétrico, Já Não Vai, Quem Já Morreu. So very famous in Salvador, ok? Estão em Salvador. Gente, some students write El Salvador. El Salvador is in Central America. Salvador is the capital of Bahia, ok? And it's just Salvador, no El, por favor. Os trios elétricos mais famosos do Brasil estão em Salvador. Como se chama o período entre a quarta-feira de cinzas e a Páscoa? So this whole thing is going to be the subject. O período, acento agudo no I, período entre a quarta-feira de cinzas e a Páscoa, acento agudo no A, Páscoa. Now the verb. Se chama, third person. Don't worry about the verb, just repeat the verb. Se chama, o período entre a quarta-feira de cinza e a Páscoa se chama Quaresma. It's easy for you to remember, because remember, it's like 40 days, right? After Carnival. 40 days of penance. Em que mês comemoramos o Natal? Nós. So, you can choose to use the subject or not, because the verb comemoramos already says that it's nós, but I prefer to use the subject. Nós comemoramos. So, in which month do we celebrate Christmas? So, nós comemoramos o Natal. Em dezembro. Isso. A que horas você se levanta? So here we are practicing the reflexive, the use of the reflexive verb. Okay, so remember, what is a reflexive verb? When the doer of the action and the receiver of the action is the same. Okay, so I get myself up. Okay, nobody has, you know, when you're old, very old, and you cannot move, so somebody's going to levantar você. So you don't use se. But when you do this effort yourself, so you have to say eu me levanto, okay? And remember the pronouns. Eu, me. Você, ele, ela, se. Nós, nos. Vocês, eles e elas, se. Okay? So just remember the three. Me, se, nos. Okay? A que horas você se levanta? So você, you always have to respond eu. Okay? Don't forget to conjugate the verb accordingly. Okay? Eu me levanto. Conjugate the verb. Eu me levanto às... You guys know what time I get up, right? Eu me levanto às 5... Não, 4 não, né, gente? 5. Às 5 horas da manhã. Or you can just say às 5 horas, ok? Eu me levanto às 5 horas, eu me levanto às 8 horas, ok? Eu me levanto às 5 horas da manhã. Você se deita cedo ou tarde? So, deitar-se means to lie down, ok? So, once again, you lie yourself down, you lie your body down. But if you're doing this, you are the doer of the action and the receiver, ok? Então, você, eu me deito cedo, ok? I go to bed early, eu me deito cedo. And, right, porque eu me levanto às 5 horas da manhã. Então, eu me deito mais ou menos às 10 horas. Você se preocupa com suas notas? So, você se preocupa? Sim, eu me preocupo com minhas. Okay, remember that, do you worry about your grades? Yes, I worry about my grades. So, read the sentence and make sure you make the necessary changes. Eu me preocupo com minhas notas. And remember that minhas, the possessive, agrees with the noun that follows it. That, you know, the thing possessed or the person possessed, okay? So notas, grades, means, is feminine plural. So you have to say minhas notas. Now, complete with the correct pronoun. Para, blah, 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 o pior dia da semana é segunda-feira. So here you're giving your opinion, so you're going to say, to me, the worst day of the week is Segunda-feira. So you see that pior, you know that it's superlative because you have the article before. If you were using the comparative, you would say segunda-feira é pior do que sábado. Ok? Então, para mim, to me, ok? O pior dia da semana é segunda-feira. Eu vou ao supermercado. Você pode ir comigo? So remember that when you use the preposition com in the first person singular, in the first person plural, you have to, it's completely different. So you say comigo, and then the rest is the same. Com você, com ele, com ela. Now, with us, conosco. Conosco. And then com eles, com elas, com vocês. Nós vamos de carros de carro com Lucas. And I do not want to hear you saying carro. Carro means expensive. Carro. It's just like who is he, okay? The pronunciation of the two R's. Okay? Nós vamos de carro com Lucas. Você também vai com ele, okay? Ela não pode ir. Ela não pode ir. She cannot come with us because she doesn't like us. Então, ela não pode ir conosco porque ela não gosta de nós. Ok? So, with the preposition de, you keep it the same. Now, with the other prepositions, me changes to me, né? Para mim, para is a preposition, so you cannot say me. Diga as festas que as palavras abaixo são associadas. Diga a que festas as palavras abaixo estão associadas. Okay, so say what parties the words below are associated with. So this, you will find this vocab in like my Portuguese lab and again, the first part of the lesson, okay? But my Portuguese lab for sure. So árvore, that's the tree. Presépio, that's the nativity scene. Neve, neve snow. Presentes e Papai Noel. So, presents, gifts, and Santa. So, Natal. Desfiles de escola de samba, fantasia, trios elétricos, forró e cerveja. Carnaval. Amendoim, that's peanuts, ok? Pipoca. Pipoca é popcorn. Bandeirinhas, the little flags that we used to decorate, festa junina. Quadrilha, that's the dance, it's kind of a square dance. And quentão, that's the drink. It's ginger tea with alcohol with cachaça. It's really good. It warms you up. Remember that when it's cold, then we have the bonfire too, right? Fogueira, okay? So just you can keep yourself warm because it's cold. Festa junina in Brazil is in the winter, right? Procissões, the processions and acting of the Passion of Christ. Velas, velas is candles, incense, and images of saints, okay? So this is Semana Santa, okay? That's the Holy Week. When, remember that I told you that, you know, after Carnival, we have Quaresma, so you think Carnaval, Quarta-feira de Cinzas, and then it start the Lent starts, okay? 40 dias. So 1 week before Easter is Semana Santa. And that's when you have these beautiful celebrations all over Brazil, especially in the small cities. The you know, acting of the Passion of Christ, it's just beautiful. It's very religious, very quiet, and it's so spiritual. It's really, really beautiful, okay? Então, Semana Santa, okay? Now, siga o modelo. Esse exercício é fácil? Sim, é facílimo. So, this is another way of using the superlative. But, guys, unless I tell you, use the superlative with íssimo, you are going to use the other superlative, okay? O maior, o menor, o mais bonito, o menos interessante, okay? Now, when I say use the íssimo form, that's when you're going to use this one. And what you have to remember is that you have four adjectives that are irregular. So, fácil, facílimo. Difícil, dificílimo. Fácil, facílimo. Difícil, dificílimo. What was the other one? Forgot. Facílimo. Esses cursos são difíceis? Sim, são. Now, cursos masculino plural. So you're going to use difícil. A acento agudo to indicate where the stress is. Dificílimo. But because cursos is masculine plural, you're going to say dificílimos. Angelina Jolie é linda? Sim, ela é, so feminine singular. Ela é, lindíssima. So if the adjective ends with a vowel, you're going to remove the vowel before you add íssimo, okay? So ela é lindíssima, because it's feminine singular. Você dorme tarde? So do you sleep late? Sim, durmo. So tarde, it ends with a vowel. Take out the vowel and add íssimo, okay? Eu durmo tardíssimo. Tardíssimo. Número 3. Tardíssimo. A Vanessa se levanta cedo? Sim, ela se levanta cedíssimo. So here you see both in dormir e levantar, you don't have to change to feminine, okay? Or plural, because you're talking about, I get up very early, okay? So you're talking about the verb levantar, okay? So don't worry about it. Cedíssimo. Sua pergunta é importante? Now you have to say, pergunta is feminine singular. Sim, é importante. Take out the vowel and add the íssimo. Importantíssima, because it's feminine singular. Um Lamborghini é caro. Now it's caro, okay? Is a Lamborghini expensive? Yes, it's very expensive. Sim, é. Take out the O, take out the vowel, and add íssimo. And caro is Lamborghini caríssimo. Caríssimo. Carro, right? Car is masculine singular, okay? As festas juninas são animadas? Não, festas juninas plural, feminine, okay? Sim, são anima. Take out the A, the vowel, and add íssimo, okay? But because it's feminine plural, you're going to say animadíssimas. So please, when you do this exercise on the test, pay attention to the subject, okay? Okay, now you're going to compare these people. So, escreva duas frases no comparativo de igualdade e duas no comparativo de desigualdade. So, here's the thing. If I give you something like this, make sure you use mais, menos, e tão e tanta, okay? Because I want to see if you know how to use one and the other, okay? So let's start. Duas no comparativo de igualdade. So igualdade, if you have a noun, you are going to use tanto, tantos, tanta, tantas. If you have an adjective, you are going to use tão, okay? So let's start here. So let's see. Carla, Lucas, Letícia. So let's see who are equal. So we can say that Carla is as punctual as Letícia. Now, pontual is an adjective, so you're going to use tão, okay? Então, Carla é, notice the verb, you have the verb ser, eu sou, você é, nós somos, eles são. Carla é tão pontual quanto, and remember that quanta never changes, it's just quanto, okay? Carla é tão pontual quanto Letícia. So now I want to find another one that has to do with tanto, because I don't want to repeat another tão, because I already know that you know how to use tão. Now I want to see if you know how to use tanto. So let's see here. Dinheiro is an adjective. A noun. So let's see who has the same amount of money. Letícia and Mateus, they have the same amount of money, right? So you're going to say Letícia, and the verb ter, eu tenho, você tem, ele tem, ela tem, nós temos, eles têm, com acento circunflexo. Letícia tem, and then dinheiro is masculine singular, so you have to say tanto dinheiro quanto, never changes, quanto Mateus. Now you have to write duas no comparativo de desigualdade. Now two in the comparative inequality. So let's see things who are different here. Let's see. Beber cerveja. Okay. So Letícia and Lucas drink more beer than Mateus and Carla. Okay. Or you can say just Lucas drinks more beer than Carla. So let's see. Lucas. So the verb beber. Eu bebo, você bebe, ela bebe, nós bebemos, eles bebem. Então Lucas bebe mais cerveja do que Carla. Now you used mais, so I want you to make a sentence with menos, okay? So let's see here. Ser otimista. We haven't used otimista. So you can say that Letícia is less optimistic than Mateus, okay? Or Lucas is less optimistic than Mateus. So let's do that one. Lucas é, don't forget the verb, é menos otimista do que Mateus. Okay? That's it. We did it. Então tá, gente. Bom jogo se vocês assistirem o Super Bowl, ok? E um ótimo resto de domingo pra vocês. Tchau, até amanhã.